Hey guys, welcome to a new video. In this one, I'm going to be working in my Hobo Nichi as usual, and I'm going to be participating in the Take 5 Art Challenge. I'll have the links to everyone below that's an official participant in the challenge. I'm not an official participant, just a random person wanting to try it out. But I'll have everyone listed below, including, I think, the leader of it. So yeah. Anyway, the whole point of the Take 5 Art Challenge is to have fun and follow a list of 5 prompts every month. And the prompts for May are to use blue and silver, to do something out of your comfort zone, to use die cuts, to do drips, and to use a medium you don't use that often. I decided, because the main colors were blue and silver, that I would draw a mermaid, because it's also mermaid, which is the draw a mermaid every day of May challenge. And so I thought it would be fitting to draw a mermaid because the color blue and it's mermaid, you know. So in my Hobo Nichi, because the paper is so thin, I tend to just kind of doodle more than do artwork that I would spend a lot of time on, because I can't really control a lot of the effects on the Tomoe River paper because of just how thin it is and the surface of the paper, the way it's so smooth and crinkly and everything. So I kind of just know going into it that I'm going to be doodling, and the results are varied. So I'm not expecting too much when I doodle. I'm just mostly trying to have fun. So I drew out the mermaid in pencil, and then I went in with a fine liner and did the inking. I really wanted her hair to have a free-flowing effect, like it's really in water, and I quite like how it turned out. And I also have her holding something that kind of looks like a seashell. And like I said, because this is a doodly kind of thing, I didn't use a reference. I just drew what kind of looked like a seashell and went with it. And here I am drawing the flowing hair that's kind of flowing up to the surface of the water, and I just love the wavy hair. I love drawing hair, it's so much fun. Here I am coming in with the first prompt, which is blue, and I'm using a Daniel Smith paint. I think it's the Prussian blue, but it might be the Mayan blue. I always get those two mixed up for some reason. And I also used some turquoise and Payne's gray and other bluish colors like that. I came in with some green, and then I tried to do some drips. I did exactly 2 drips, and the results were okay, I guess. It kind of went off the page, and I soaked it up with some toilet paper, but yeah. So that was a lot of fun, and drips was one of the prompts as well. And so I just like to really add texture with all of the granulating pigments and everything, and I really love that effect in my work. And I decided to keep the figure herself kind of lightly colored, and then the area around her has the more intense colors, because I want her to pop out of the background. I don't want her to just disappear in it. So that's kind of what I did. And then I remembered that I had to add silver as a prompt, so I took out my Fintech Pearl color paints and just activated the silver with some water and tapped some drops and just had fun with it. And it actually sparkled and shined way more than I expected. Like, this page is so shiny, as you'll see at the end, and I really didn't expect it to be that shiny. I really like it, but whoa, it's like crazy. So then I came in with a new to me material, which is my Caran d'Ache Neo Color 2 pencils. And I used that for one of my prompts, which is use a medium you don't use often. Well, considering that it's brand new to me and I haven't really used it before, I decided that that would be perfect. And it also, this whole page kind of feels outside of my comfort zone, because I'm not used to using this many mediums on one Hobo Nichi page, so it's pretty crazy for me. So I definitely think it fits that other prompt. And let's see, what prompts are left? I think the only one left is die cuts, which you can see that little leaf die cut on the other page, which I ended up using. And then basically I'm auditioning all of the other die cuts to see if I want to use them. And I think I used 3 die cuts. And I really love that wild and free, because I felt like the girl was kind of wild and free in the water, and I really loved it. So I added that with some iridescent tape. And then and I decided to use the underneath part of that die cut as a writing spot, which worked out really well because I left that portion of the paper without much paint so that I'd have like an easy area to write in. And then I decided that the mermaid needed more color, so I ended up coloring in her skin with a brown pencil crayon. And I made her tail blue, I think, and I made her top blue as well. And then I used a white Uniball Signo broad gel pen to color in the pearls around her neck. So they really stood out white. And yeah, you can already see the pearlescent silver paint drying on the paper, and it's like so shiny. I really love how it turned out. It looks so magical. Guys, thank you so much for watching my video. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. It really helps my channel out so much to help it grow. And feel free to take part in the Take 5 Art Challenge. Like I said, all links will be below. And check out all the other artists who participated. All right, guys, see you later. Peace.